The LeBron James of soccer wins it for Chelsea. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another match review. This is Chelsea 1, West Ham 0. What a roller coaster of emotions in this game, or really a roller coaster towards the end, because at the beginning I was honestly trying not to fall asleep. It was quite boring. But before we get into the video, you guys know the drill. If you like my channel, if you like this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button to support me. And yeah, that's it. Let's get into this match review. As always, starting with the starting 11, Edouard Mendy in goal. We had a back five of Ruben Loftus-Cheek, Christensen, Thiago Silva, Azpilicueta, Marcos Alonso, Conte and Jorginho in the middle of the pitch, and then Mason Mount, Timo Werner, and Kai Havertz up front. There was a slight change as right before kickoff, Christensen apparently had some stomach pain, so Trevor Chalaba came on instead, and honestly, I was kind of happy to see Chalaba getting an opportunity. A lot of people were saying before the match why he wasn't, and I don't think that Christensen has put in the best performances recently. I feel that he's had like quite a few concentration lapses, and so for me, I was happy to see Trevor given a chance. He had been making a lot of mistakes like when he was playing a while ago, but that's kind of to be expected by a young player, and for me, I figured, okay, well, it makes sense. Azpilicueta moved over to left center back, yet another position that we've seen him play in. And other than that, I felt like we didn't really have, like, the starting 11 was to be expected. Now, this first half was boring. There's no other way to put it. I was falling asleep in this first half. Chelsea were moving the ball so slowly. Neither team had even a shot on target. West Ham were just sitting back, crowding the midfield so that it was so difficult for any Chelsea player to try to create anything. Chelsea couldn't get any balls in behind. Like, they were all just like, I don't know, like Chelsea were just moving the ball so slowly, and they couldn't create anything, and it was super frustrating. At one point, I think, or maybe more than one point, but at one point I counted like at least 6 West Ham players in a line. Like, that was their first back line, and then like a handful more ahead. So it was super defensive, and they weren't even playing their best team. They play in the semi-final of the Europa League on Thursday, so they had a lot of people rested. I believe that Dawson was their only like senior fit center back even playing. Like, it was not a strong West Ham team. Declan Rice wasn't starting either. So this is a team that we probably like should have beaten quite easily, or more easily than we did. Second half starts, no subs made. Seems like Chelsea are moving the ball a little bit better. There's a couple of shots, like finally there's a couple of shots in the game, but again, it just feels like Chelsea are dragging it out. It just feels like that Real Madrid game took absolutely everything out of the players, and I can imagine like it must have completely taken so much mentally and physically, and then to get knocked out after that performance and have to come back and still perform, it's difficult. I understand that, but the performance, it just felt like, oh, it's not going to be enough. That's how I was feeling. And you know, I had thought that the top four race was not the top four race, but I had thought that the top three race, at least, like the top four race for us, was done and dusted, like that we would have secured third place. And it's looking more and more that that's not the situation. Finally, in the 85th, 86th minute, Lukaku wins a penalty. And Lukaku has looked like so just like out of sorts with the rest of the team. He's pointing, he's trying to make runs, they don't pass to him. It's like they just don't understand each other at all. But he wins the penalty. Dawson gets sent off for a red card for denying a goal scoring opportunity. Jorginho steps up. He's looking nervous. Like, normally he looks much more cool and collected. And I was thinking, like, this guy has gone through so much this season. I think he's still recovering from Italy missing out on the World Cup. And that must, like, take a massive toll on him. I can only imagine. But he didn't look in the right mind space, in my opinion, to be taking the penalty. But he's Chelsea's set penalty taker. He was on the field, so he takes it. It was one of the worst penalties I have ever seen. Like, just no power, not placed, the goalkeeper has time to, like, if he tries to go another way, he has a perfect amount of time to go and save that. And I was like, that's it. That's the game. That's the game. And it really would have summed up how Chelsea had played, because it was not a good performance at all. 89th minute, Mason Mount is driving forward. Marcos Alonso gets the ball and he pulls it back. And who's there but Christian Pulisic? He scores. Chelsea get the 3 points. They win 1-0 to Chelsea. What a roller coaster. I must say, like, Christian Pulisic tends to come up with these big goals for Chelsea, and he has this, like, big game mentality that he scores in big games, and he hasn't been the most consistent. But one of the things that I love about Christian Pulisic is that he is always making runs and timing his runs into the box really well, and he's one of the only players that you see doing that. I don't see that from enough players. So I was very happy that he was on the pitch, because I feel like if anybody else was, I don't know if that would have been a goal, because that's something that Christian Pulisic does really, really, really well. It's a win for Chelsea. Is it a good game? No. Was it a good performance? No. At this point in the season, like, we just have the FA Cup really and top four to fight for. And I think the important thing is making sure that we don't slip in that top four race, because even though we have a game in hand over Arsenal, we still are just a couple of points clear of them. Any missed points, any drop points could be crucial, and we could find ourselves, like, without Champions League football potentially if we let ourselves slip. So it's really important to be on top of our games. And so even though it's not a good performance, I'm kind of just hoping for us to make it through till the end of this season, get through that FA Cup final, hopefully win it. But not gonna lie, I'm feeling quite nervous after the recent performances that we've had. I feel like Chelsea and Thomas Tuchel, like, need a reset. All of the ownership stuff needs to be sorted. We need to sort the players' contracts and players going in and out and whatever. And yeah, so that basically sums up how I'm feeling. I'm kind of, like, a little bit like disjointed, if that's a word. Yeah, I think so, because it was just a roller coaster of emotions. I wasn't expecting to be recording a win, and it wasn't the best of performances, like I mentioned, but a win's a win, and that's what I tweeted. A win's a win, 3 points. That's what's important at this point in the season. So guys, hope that you enjoyed this match review. If you liked it, make sure to drop a like, comment, let me know your thoughts about the game, and sub to my channel as we're finishing up another season. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day or evening, whatever your time you're watching this. And until next time, I'm out. Bye.